The movie Contact famously depicted an alien radio signal that, when decoded, provided plans for the construction of a faster-than-light device so that a human representative could travel and meet the aliens. This was a rather benign way of making first contact, though it doesn't seem to have done Jodie Foster's character much good. Outside of fiction, we don't seem to have a network of wormholes that we can use to go and interact with exocivilizations, and if intelligent life is somewhat rare in the galaxy, not an unreasonable notion, traveling the great distances of space to actually physically meet them seems out of reach, at least until the far future. But there may be another way it could happen, and it's a method that has somewhat scary implications. The idea was first proposed by physicist Vahi Gurzadyan. It traces back to something called Kolmogorov complexity, essentially the length of a computer program that can enable the complete recovery of compressed data. Think of it like this. If you write a program that describes a string of information, say a randomly generated string of letters and numbers, it would be so complex that the program designed to describe the string is nearly as big as the information string itself. But if you have something that's not complex, say a string of 200,000 alternating ones and zeros, all you need is a program that says print 200,000 alternating ones and zeros. No need to send all 200,000 digits. He also looked at the human genome and found that it's actually not that complex in the sense. You could send a program that reconstructs the human genome without too much difficulty with an Arecibo-style transmitter. This would allow an alien civilization to send us its genetic code, and from that we could reconstruct a member of the alien species and interact with it without ever leaving Earth. But there's more. Since he found that life on Earth shares much of its genetics, without too much more effort, we could send the entirety of the genomes of all life on Earth. This would allow for the reconstruction of virtually all of an alien planet's ecosystem, all in a SETI signal. We can send us to them, and they can reconstruct, essentially, Earth. Likewise, we could reconstruct, essentially, their planet by terraforming, say, Mars, and getting their life going on it. If it turns out truly possible, then this has broad implications. It may mean that the galaxy is full of alien civilizations transmitting their genomes to each other, leading ultimately to colonies of aliens from across the galaxy. These transplants would have no direct connection to the world they evolved on, yet be living next to other aliens native to a star system that sent their data to the transplant's original world. But could this also be malicious in a Borg collective kind of way? Well, it's probably not very likely unless a civilization is stupid enough to reconstruct species from another world that could be dangerous. Or slate wiper viruses, or arch predators looking to feed and reproduce using radio astronomy. After all, this would be a roundabout way to reproduce just as much as any other method. But a civilization with a command of genetics solid enough to reconstruct these genomes very likely would be able to determine what they're going to get before reconstructing the creatures themselves. And there is a variant in all of this. If a civilization wanted to simply say hello and say they once visited our world long ago, something for which there is no indication of, they might send genomes of past creatures that were clearly native to Earth. Think a SETI signal that contains genetic information to bring back trilobites or tyrannosaurs. This might be considered a gift of sorts. Give a species back lost genetic information so they can study DNA that disappeared long ago when those species went extinct. Think a snapshot of all Earth life in, say, the late Cretaceous. Another variant would be for civilizations to send out von Neumann or Bracewell probes that can receive the data from the original civilization, print out an ecosystem on a world, and colonize. Perhaps federations of aliens might find worlds suitable for one member species' ecosystem and print it out there, but then would print out an entirely different, more cold-tolerant species' ecosystem on the next world out in a system with multiple habitable worlds. In the end, if we ever did detect such information in a signal, it may end up not being decodable. But it's an interesting idea nonetheless, and it does suggest that perhaps maybe we should be looking at the noise of deep space for bits of strings. And, at least in principle, it is possible that such a von Neumann probe once visited this world very early in Earth's history and printed out and deposited life on Earth in a kind of interstellar panspermia. Thanks for listening. I am futurist and science fiction author John Michael Godier, currently giving a heads up for Star Trek fans that watch this channel. In a special edition on Event Horizon next Tuesday, I did a show with the hosts of The Well podcast, award-winning filmmaker Brandon Edgins and actor, writer, and producer Anson Mount, who also just happened to portray Captain Christopher Pike in Star Trek Discovery. Link to their podcast in the description below. And be sure to check out my books at your favorite online book retailer, and subscribe to my channels for regular in-depth explorations into the interesting, weird, and unknown aspects of this amazing universe in which we live.